design software these days has moved to being available on a subscription model, meaning that you pay monthly or yearly and you get upgrades as the software is improved, rather than just purchasing outright one specific version of the software and owning that for life. This model has its pros and cons. On the plus side, it's good to be able to keep up with the latest releases easily without having to fork out for a whole new version of the software. But then also paying every single month, these costs can really add up. You're paying for access rather than paying to own the software. Really though, we don't have a choice because, like I said, most design software is moving towards that subscription model these days. So for this video, I've decided to do a bit of a stock take of the apps and software that I'm subscribed to and tell you a bit about them. The most expensive software I use is Adobe Creative Cloud, and it's kind of fair enough that it's the most expensive because it's also probably the one that I use the most. I actually got a free year subscription to this at VidCon, which was pretty exciting, but when that runs out, I'm going to be having to pay £45.73 a month, which is obviously quite steep. I also have a subscription to this through work, but obviously work pays for the one that I use there. Adobe does offer a much cheaper subscription if you only want to use one or two apps. I think you can pay like £15 or something per app to access them. But I end up using Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, Adobe Premiere, After Effects, maybe Lightroom every now and then as well. So it's worth it for me to have the full package. I know some people have stuck with the older versions before they move to the subscription model. But I do think that the updates they've done in Creative Cloud are worth it. Things run much smoother and much better, and there's much better features now. So I think it's worth it if you do design professionally. And if you're still studying, they do have a student price as well. I'm not quite sure what it is, but I know it's a lot cheaper than £45 a month. Up until a few years ago, Adobe was actually the only design software that I really used, but then Sketch came along, and I've done a video all about Sketch, like a 101 tutorial that I'll link to on a card up there for you to go watch. This is what I use for web design. Sketch fairly recently moved to a more subscription type model, but it's kind of different to how Adobe does it. Instead of paying for access, you're paying for upgrades in a way. You pay $99 and that gives you a year's worth of upgrades. At the end of that year, you can just keep using the software as much as you want. You just don't get the upgrades from then on if you don't want to keep paying for them. I really like this model they've chosen because it means that it's much easier for people to access the software without having to basically commit themselves to a lifetime of paying for it. But then professionals are obviously going to keep upgrading and keep paying per year because they want to use the latest updates and the latest features. I love Sketch. It's a huge help to my web design process, and I'm going to be making more videos about it for sure with some more tips and tricks and things. So let me know what you'd like to know about it, I suppose, and I'll make sure that's included in the video. Next up, something else I use at work is InVision, and this is a web app service, I guess you'd call it, for prototyping and gathering feedback on designs. You upload your web designs into the software, you can make links clickable to jump around between pages, you can make little notes so that when you send it to someone, they've got some context behind what you were doing in specific parts, and people that you share it with can also leave comments, which is really useful. I use this for gathering all feedback on my designs so that everything is in one place. At work, we're on the $25 plan, which gives us unlimited prototypes, but they do have cheaper ones as well, and you can actually use it for free if you just have one project that you need to put in there. Another one at work is the Nab Project. Nab Project is a site where people upload vector icons for different things, and you can just search for whatever object that you need an icon for, and there will be many different options to choose from. They're mostly available under the Creative Commons license if you want to just use them for free, but if you'd like to just use them in your project without having to put the little line of credit anywhere, then you can subscribe to Noun Pro. You pay a fee of $9.99, I think it is, per month, and you get access to all of the icons you want. I prefer to create my own icons, but I often use this as a starting point, as a reference, or for just quick things to go on social media, for example, that don't need me to spend a lot of time on them if there's already something that's perfectly suitable waiting in the Noun Project. Next up is To-Do, which, just like it sounds, is a to-do list app. I first started using this when you just paid a fee to download the iPhone app and then you could access it. They moved to a subscription model though to be able to, you know, keep funding it and keep developing it, and it's only $2 a month, which is pretty cheap. It does sound strange, I know, that I pay to use a to-do list app because I know there are many, many free ones out there, but honestly, this is the one I love. This is the one that keeps me organized, so I'm perfectly happy to pay that $2 a month to be able to use it. The last app I'm subscribed to isn't design software, but I guess it's kind of about productivity, and that is Spotify. I find that having music on in the background is vital to my design process. It can help block out the rest of the office noise. It can help me focus. You know, I've got certain playlists that if I need to get inspired or if I need to concentrate. So that's why I'm including it in this video, and that is £9.99 a month. So that is the software that I'm subscribed to. I'd love to hear if your list is similar. there's some other things that you pay for monthly or yearly that perhaps I didn't mention, leave them down below in the comments. That'd be interesting to hear about. I am going to be doing another video in the series all about the free apps that I use as part of my process, so stay tuned for that. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and if you're new to my channel, please make sure you subscribe because I make new videos about design every single week. And I guess I will see you in the next one.